Some days, I wish there was more than one of me. Just for a couple of days. What's happening, guys? Dan Debenham here. Just occasionally, I want more than one of me. Just more than one of me to do the stuff I don't want to do. And to just, it would just make life a lot easier if there was a couple of Dans who could just do stuff and we could just get on with it and I could concentrate on doing other things and leave some of the other jobs to somebody else. That isn't the case, but in video, specifically in Adobe Premiere Pro, we can clone ourselves. Now, there are a multitude of videos out there that do this. It'll show you how to put a mask down the middle and you've got two people sat side by side, etc, etc. In this tutorial, what we're going to do is we're going to take it a tiny step further. We're going to clone ourselves, but we're also going to interact with ourselves. So, without further ado, let's get downstairs to the lounge where I've set up shop and we're going to interact with ourselves. So let me explain it downstairs. In this tutorial, what we're going to do is we're going to pass a mobile phone between myself. So, a couple of things you need. First thing is, you need a mobile phone, obviously, because without that, we can't do that. But you also need change of clothes. So we've got changes of clothes here for the other me, so that you look significantly different or just different enough in order for people to recognize that it is you, but you wouldn't be dressed exactly the same because you're not twins, etc. You're trying to convey that this is a completely different entity. Now, in order to pass something to yourself, like this mobile phone, you can't pass it and then do the grabbing from the other end at the right height and speed and pace that you would normally do a pass. So to do that, what you actually need is you need an assistant for that. So today what I've got is I've got Louise, who is my wife. She's going to be my assistant. I'm lucky that Louise is similar height to me, similar size, so sitting on the sofa and stuff, we're going to get a similar imprint. So with that, let's get on with sorting out this actual shot. Just to sort of get the memory and the feeling of where this is going to actually be. This is now live on the actual final camera as well, so we're using the actual final scene. So this is roughly what it will look like. Are you comfortable with that? Okay, right, so if you want to go outside then, you know what you're saying, is that right? Yeah, cool. And we'll start the scene, so I'll call action on this in a second, once we've got ourselves right. Okay, action.
Have a great film.
Come on, mate. And cut, okay. So what we'll do now is do that again. Just do it, we'll do it two or three times just to make sure that we get a positive pass across and we know that everything looks similar to where it's gonna be. We'll do the same with the other side. Okay, so we've got the idea. We've seen how we set that shot up. We've got some supplementary shots. Those shots are gonna sell this scene as a real scene because there's a bit before and a bit after and then the bit in the middle, which is the actual money sort of thing that we're looking for. This is the pass out there. Let's get into Adobe Premiere and let's put this together and see how we get around some of the issues that we've got. Okay, so we are now into Premiere Pro and we've got our clips in our timeline. We've got everything set and ready to go and we have the clips sat over the top of each other. What I'm going to advise you to do would be to marker where the handover is. So I've marked where the handover is so I know exactly where I am and where I'm coming in. So I'm coming in roughly around there, so I put a marker in to know when that, when I've started walking, and then where the handover is. We've got two clips. We've got the first clip, which is basically me taking the, which is the top clip, which is me taking the phone. And then we also have a bottom clip, which is me handing the phone, like so. So what we're going to do is we're going to put that on like that. We're going to get to the point where the handover happens just so that we know that we're in the right area. We're going to reduce our clip to 25%. Click on our top clip and then we're going to go to mask, so opacity mask, like so. Click outside there, and what we're going to do is we're going to bring this in somewhere around where the light switch is. Light is effectively fetching through the center there, like so. But here, what we're going to do is we're going to put a couple of markers. I'm going to bring it through at a slight angle, so it's a bit jaunty, and there is a particular reason for that, and that is so it basically gives us some wiggle room. Once we connect it up and we've connected all that together, you will see that we've ended up with both sides, and you can see that we're already in a situation where we've got things looking something like how they should be. So if I just click off that, so that we're not connected to it in any way, we can see it's not quite right here, because we've got the clip on the top is a little bit too low. So we're going to change that to 960. Should bring the clip up a little bit. There we go, it's brought that clip up a little bit. And we're just going to go for the pass over just to see what that looks like. Now you can see it's not quite right, that. So I'm going to go 965. I'm just going to drop it slightly. It might be 970, might work okay for this, as it's quite fast anyway. And we just sort of make sure that we're looking at clip and that it's going to do what I want it to do. And if that's not quite right, what we can actually do is we can click on the mask, like so, and we can just adjust it a little bit so that we get a little bit more in here. So if I make that now to 970, which is where it roughly wants to be. Click off there and see what is happening with that. Okay, so we're getting there. We're not too bad. We're not too far away now from where we want to be. We just need to add in a couple more points. Maybe that one. Up like so, and bring that in. I'm going to bring that up and across like that, and we're going to just keep messing around with this until we get it roughly about where we want it to be. So we're going to add a few more points in. And this serves to sort of obfuscate the mask itself, basically. So I'm going to put the mask feather up to 22. That just gives it a little bit more of a blur. So we'll just have a look at what that looks like now. And the passover is pretty cool. And we can see the roof is still a little bit out there, so what we can do is we can just go back into the mask and we'll just bring that down slightly, so that's down here. So we've got very little offset, and it comes round, but we're still maintaining this mask here, we're still maintaining this passover here. Which makes it all the more realistic. Okay, so the next bit that we need to do is we need to add in some supplementary shots of what's actually happening. So what I'll do is I'll put an image of me. This is a handheld of me right at the beginning. So what we do is we'll drag that in. And this is a handover of me doing that. I'll also sell this by sticking the image of me scrolling through. So we'll scroll through on that as well. That brings that forward. Like so. So let's get those up to 200%. So that we can see what's happening with those. What I'm going to do is I'm going to copy the colour correction of that and paste that onto there just to see if that looks like it should. Hopefully it will match. And we'll shorten that down to just a few frames. Grab the whole thing. Drag that in, like that. And then we'll come back out from here. And we'll drop into this clip, which is another clip I've taken, which is of me watching the TV. Like so. I'm going to bring that in, see, how do I change my head? No, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring it from about there. And then drop that there, like so. Bring that up to 200%. Like that. Control click and then paste attributes on there, which basically lightens that up, which is cool. So now we have a scene, me watching TV. That's amazing. I quite like that. That's really, really good. And then what I can do then is for the whole thing, what I'll do is we'll just go and we'll drop a square on, like so. Go to 25%. We'll just drag that up here like this, drag it across, and then we'll Alt and just drag it to place. What I'm going to do with that is I'm going to duplicate it, bring that one down like so, shift, hold shift down just to make sure they're roughly around about the same size. Okay, so we've selected that. We'll go into our effects panel, go up to black, do the same with this one, stroke to full black like so. We'll grab these, drag them onto videos, video 4 and video 5, right to the very beginning, drag it to the full clip, so the full clip is throughout. So now what you're getting is you're getting some black bars, top and bottom, which also sells the issue as well, sells that crossover as well, because it looks a little bit more cinematic. So you're expecting it to be fairly cinematic and fairly interesting. Okay, so let's just take a look at what the final scene looked like. We've added a little bit of music to that as well, just to give it some sort of feel and to give an emotion to it. I hope this tutorial was useful. I hope that it gave you some insight in how to do some of those things. again, you can take it forward from this very basic sort of this is how we interact into something more complicated. You could do a putting something down and then somebody else picking it up. The sea of options is so wide and so deep that it's just the world is your oyster. So I hope it was useful. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you guys next time. Oh, and by the way, don't forget to subscribe and like below, and get more videos and get more updates. Follow me on Instagram, follow me on Twitter for more updates, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.